Hello everyone, this is Becca Feeken with Amazing Paper Grace, and today I'm sharing a new die from my Amazing Paper Grace collection because you never know when the next gift-giving occasion is around the corner. I'm going to be showing you how to embellish a bag box for any occasion, and I'm going to be using a couple of dies, the Favorably Simple Gift Box, Swirling Grace, and then also the tiered multi-loop bows. These are the die cuts you're going to need for the box, but no worries, the entire supply list is on the website. Each die is cut and then it is run through a second time and embossed, and I'm going to demonstrate that with the Swirling Grace die. There are three large pieces that fit concentrically, and I'm securing them with washi tape so that I can get a consistent border all the way around. Once I have them secured, I'll run them through my machine using gold cardstock. And then once they are run through once, I'll take another turn and I'll emboss them. This is what it'll look like when you're finished. There's a pretty easy method to getting this box put together the same way every time. You'll see by the layout I have the bag portion with one up, one down, and then I have the two gold pieces. Go ahead and flex all of your score lines, and then for the rectangle at the bottom of the bag, we're going to use 1/4 inch score tape. And it's going to look like this. Fold back all of the tabs on the box pieces. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna butt the bottom tab up against the sides of the rectangle. And by doing that, it's going to be square. So if you'll butt it up and then just run your finger over your bottom tab, it'll be adhered in place. And then you'll take the upper part of the bag and you will center it right over the other rectangle. And then you'll just score all your lines. We're going to go ahead next and we're going to fold down one of the flaps that holds the box closed, and we're going to adhere that permanently. And then we're going to take the center mechanism and we're going to go ahead and engage it. Now you remember, you already have adhesive. So once you have this in place, all your lines are scored and folded in, you can simply lift the edges and it's gonna get your box set up very squarely. And now for the embellishment, I'm gonna take Swirling Grace, cut it in half and put glue on the ends. So then to apply it, I simply press it down and press those edges in so the glue will catch, and do that on both sides. For closure, I take a Velcro dot and I put it on the flap that we still have open on the front. And now our last embellishment is the bow. With a multi-loop bow, I cut two of the smallest loops and two tails. I take a pencil or a round object and I just curl those loops around it. It makes for a very nice presentation. And then I put everything together with a pearl brad. Now you can use glue if you like, but I love using a brad because that means you can move the bow and gesture it later on. And so there you have it. All we need to do is put the bow on the front of the box with a glue gun. And now you have an all-purpose box bag combination you can use for any gift-giving occasion. If you've made a card, well then go ahead and incorporate the same die that you used for the card onto the box for an elegant ensemble. This will carry you from casual to dressy, from something like a teacher's gift, all the way up to your bridesmaid's gifts. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and we're so eager to hear what you think about the box. Thanks for stopping by, friends. We'll see you soon.